Welcome in the third lecture of the infrared spectroscopy. So how we can study the energetics? So we have to use a model which is harmonic oscillator, and harmonic oscillator obeys Hooke's law, and the energy, the potential energy we get the harmonic oscillator or the periodic motion like simple pendulum or Hooke's law is given by this one, half k x square. And x it's r minus r zero. If you fix the one atom and compress the other to this position or elongate it to this one, you get this parabola. Okay, and the frequency of vibration is given by this equation, and you can get the wave number by this. We just divide by a by c value. I'm going to show you an example to in the next slide. Strong absorption of the HCl is given at this frequency value. You can calculate how you can calculate the force constant and how you can calculate the shift if you change the H with the deuterium atom. This, you will use this equation to get this force constant. It's direct use to this equation, okay, and it's equal to this value, Newton by meter. And as you know, if you change the H with deuterium, the reduced mass is increased, so the vibrational should decrease. What you need to do is that just to get the square root of HCl divided by mu of the deuterium chloride. So there is a shift in the frequency by this value. Okay, the quantum harmonic oscillator, so we have to solve Schrodinger equation. And this is the potential energy we get before, and this is the frequency. There is a relation between the linear frequency and the omega. So omega equal to pi nu, so the omega is equal to k over mu. And this is also Schrodinger equation in one dimension, in x dimensional or x direction only. This is the same like this one. And after solving Schrodinger equation, we get the energetics given by this one, and this is by joule. And we will see a new quantum number. It's given here by n. It's a vibrational quantum number, and its value 0, 1, 2, 3. It should be integer. And this is, you can change this new with omega with this relation to get this one. Also, the energy is still in joule. You can convert it from joule to centimeter minus 1. Just you have to divide it by HC, and you end up with this value, and this is new dash, which is the wave number. Okay, this is, we solve Schrodinger equation to get the or to have an information about the wave function. This is the wave function of the Schrodinger equation. This is when n equal to 0, n equal to 1 2 3 4, and so on. And this is the energetics, just substitute to in this equation by the value of n by 0, we will get the 0 point energy, and E1, 3 over 2, h nu, or h bar omega, and so on. And you will see the distance between energy levels are equidistant, as you have seen. Okay, what I want to see here, you see the wave function is get out of the border, which in contrast with the particle inbox wave function, and this is called tunneling. The tunneling is defined as the presence of the particle in a forbidden, in classically forbidden area. This is tunneling. Okay, the quantum harmonic oscillator, from Schrodinger equation you get this expression, and this is the value of n or v here. It's a vibrational quantum number. It's given the units for this one, it's centimeter minus 1. Okay, just we apply with 0 and 1 to get this energy levels. Also, Schrodinger equation tell us about the selection rule. Dipole moment must change when delta V is equal plus or minus 1. Plus 1 absorption, minus 1 emission. And you know, the vibrating molecule interacts with the EMR of its own oscillating frequency. Okay, and this is the spectra. You will see only one peak because the difference between any two energy level is the same. It's equal to h nu. Okay, and that's why IR, it's called the fingerprint, because each functional group or each vibration has a certain only one frequency, okay? The same like previous slides, this is the harmonic oscillator, energy levels, and this is the, these are the transition, and this is the spectra, just only one peak, and this is the selection rules, okay? So let us go to anharmonic oscillator. Harmonic oscillator does not study the bond association. Real molecules don't obey exactly the law of simple harmonic motion. If the bond between the atom is stretched, there comes out a point at which the bond will break. The molecule will dissociate into atoms. The harmonic oscillator, the parabola, does not discuss this bond association. So what else? We will see a function which is given by Morse, which is called the Morse potential, which can deal with the bond association. This Morse potential function is given by this one, and D is the dissociation energy, and DE is the depth of the potential energy minimum. This is Morse potential. Okay, the Morse potential, when you put it in the Schrodinger equation and solve it, we got this energy expression. This is a wave number in centimeter minus one, and this is the equilibrium frequency, and this is the anharmonicity, XE anharmonicity constant, and the omega equilibrium vibrational frequency. Also V here, or which is, or you can use it N, it's okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, it's integer. And the value of anharmonicity, it's around 10 to the power minus 2. Okay, there is a relation between the equilibrium frequency and the oscillating frequency is given by this one. So this one is decreased by increasing the value of vibrational quantum number. Okay, let's go to the spectra. I hope I can finish it before the time. Also, selection rules here, it's plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3. It's not the same like the harmonic one. So when delta V it's equal to plus or minus 1, we get the fundamental peak. If it's more than 2 or 3, we get overtones, first overtone and second overtone. So we have many peaks here for the Morse potential. This is the fundamental one, the tallest one, and the orange one, this one is the first overtone and second overtone. There is some frequency in the blue line. What's this? It's called hot bands. If you give some heat to the molecule, it will accept, it will gain some energy, and can the population in the first excited state, it increase. So it can the transition can happen from this one to the upper energy levels. Okay, so spectrum of an harmonic oscillator, it's fundamental given by this expression, omega oscillation, and the first overtone and second overtone. And this is an example how to calculate the equilibrium vibrational frequency or anharmonicity and so on. And this is its solution. You can see solution of this one. So, and this is some typical IR spectrometer. This is the source, and this is reflecting mirror, and the sample put here, and this is the reference line. This combination between two peaks, and this is the detector, and so on. With this one, I think I finished my the lecture of the IR spectroscopy. I hope you get the points. If you need any question, just write in the comments or just send me, and I will answer you. Until we meet again, I hope you all the best, and I wish you get the points what I want to reach them to you. The points I want to reach them to you, and bye bye.